and then formed man and woman in his own image. Several thousand years after the flood, when God made the rainbow shine forth as the sign of the covenant. 21 centuries from the time of Abraham and Sarah. 13 centuries after Moses led the people of Israel out of Egypt. 1,100 years from the time of Ruth and the Judges. 1,000 years from the anointing of David as king in the 65th week, according to the prophecy of Daniel. In the 194th Olympiad, the 752nd year from the foundation of the city of Rome, the 42nd year of the reign of Octavian Augustus, the whole world being at peace. Jesus Christ, eternal God and Son of the eternal Father, desiring to sanctify the world by this most merciful coming, being conceived by the Holy Spirit, and 9 months having passed since his conception, was born in Bethlehem, Judea, of the Virgin Mary. Today is the Nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to the flesh.
Thank you.
eleison.
Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the bar of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Appeared, bringing salvation to all, training us to resound in piety and worldly passions, and in the present age to live lives that are self-controlled, upright, and godly, while we wait for the blessed hope and the manifestation of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. He it is who gave himself a people of his own, who are zealous for good deeds. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. This was the first registration and was taken while Briones was governor of Syria. All went to their own town to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and the family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over by their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is the Messiah of the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." The Gospel of our Lord.
Decided on a census, and they all had to comply. It may have seemed like a little thing to Caesar, but to a woman's family, it was a major disruption. There was a lot of talk buzzing about, and there was a lot of resentment, but no one could do anything about it. Everybody had to go to the place of their ancestors, and there they had to be counted. Well, the woman and her family, they went to Bethlehem, since that's where her husband Amos' people were from. The thing she couldn't figure out was why they had to be counted anyway. Some say it was for the taxes, but since they had nothing, it seemed especially pointless for her family to go. But she had to go, like it or not. And so she went. What a trip. It was hard enough to take care of kids at home, but traveling, it's impossible, especially when one of the littlest was sick with a fever most of the way. As it turned out, the afternoon that they finally arrived, where the Roman soldiers were taking the names and were asking people all of the official questions and writing down the answers on long scrolls, she was the ninth woman to be counted. The ninth woman. She doesn't remember, but for some reason, the number 9 stuck in her mind. Amos of Galilee, the 14th man on this day to be counted, they said. 4 male children, 3 female children, and his wife, the 9th woman counted. All the while they were doing their job, the Roman soldiers were joking and they were laughing and they weren't taking their work all that seriously. They certainly weren't paying attention to her family. The 9th woman, number 9. It was hard and bare, a number like that, so simple, so matter of fact, so distant, almost irrelevant somehow. Amos' wife shivered Her feet hurt, her mouth was dry, and their little daughter was still hot with fever. The ninth woman, it kept echoing in her mind. Well, afterward, when the man said that they were all done and that they could go along, they had to find a place to stay, but there weren't any places. Those who could afford to stay in the inns, well, they tried, but even now those places were overflowing. Some were lucky enough to have family in Bethlehem who could put them up for the night. But many didn't. The least fortunate ones, well, they did the best that they could. There was a man that Amos met while he was standing in line. They had been talking about where they would spend the night. He mentioned that some people were being allowed to stay in a cave. It was a place where animals were kept. But they went anyway. At least, if nothing else, it would be a place to get out of the wind. But oh, it was crowded. There were animals, animals of every kind, and there were people, people everywhere, tucked into every little corner. And then, in the corner of that dark place, there was a woman who started to groan. She began to make sharp cries, like a wounded animal, and people began to look around, and they whispered to one another, and some spoke more loudly, wondering who and what it was. Well, Amos' wife, the ninth woman, knew immediately what it was. She felt sorry for her. This was not much of a place to give birth. The young woman, oh, she wailed again. And the ninth woman knew this was going to be a long night. She knew that the laboring mom was going to need some help. But oh, she was so tired. She remembered again how much her feet hurt. They had come such a long way. Her kids were crying. The little one was still feverish, but sometimes you do what you have to do. Well, the young woman's eyes were wide. She was frightened. The pain, it seemed to surprise her, as it often does in the first time. It was good that Amos' wife, the ninth woman, was there. She knew what to expect, and she could tell this first-time mother what was coming. She could reassure her, tell her that this is exactly what her body was created to do. She did what she needed to do. Sometimes she got right to the face of the young mother and told her to be strong, keep focused. Bite your shawl, not your lip, she told her once. The birth, it took a while, and it wasn't an easy one. Amos' wife reminded the new mom that that pain that she felt, it was okay. It hurt, yes, but it was helping the baby to come out. Finally, when he did arrive, she cleaned him off with a bit of crumpled hay, much like she would with a small animal in a barn. The father suddenly appeared. He had an old blanket, and together they swaddled the baby. Everyone, they were exhausted. But the energy of the women who were around, it was lifted a little bit as they watched the new mother hold her son. There's nothing like seeing what happens when a mother and child are together for their first moments. Amos' wife, she had seen it so many times as she'd helped the women in her own village give birth. And then she stopped for a moment. She laughed at herself, ironically, really. She looked around at the surroundings. This was a first, she thought. A cave full of people, a huge number of animals, a howling wind, all in an unexpected place. And here, a new mother and child. Well, her thoughts were interrupted by the voice of the new mother, who was now looking up at her. And she said, "What is your name?" It was as if the woman hadn't heard. And the young mother asked again, "What is your name?" And she responded, "Leah." The young mother looked at Leah and held the child and said, "Leah, this is Jesus. This is Jesus." smiled. She realized that it was the first time that anybody had called her by her name since they left home. Not a number, not the ninth woman, but a name. Not some man's wife, not she was here just because of Amos, but Leah, her name. Not some nebulous appellation, her name, Leah. And it felt good. Leah touched Mary's forehead, and she stroked Jesus' soft cheek. And then Leah held on to the mother's hand for a while, until both mother and child fell asleep. But finally, Leah went back across the cave. Once Mary and the baby were settled in, now things were much quieter, and she lay down with her own children. She held them close. The children, yes, indeed, they were still awake, but they were very quiet in the dark. Their eyes all moved about. They'd seen. They'd witnessed. They knew. And it was like they were struggling to make sense of it all. It was as if they had a secret and they didn't know what questions to ask or to tell. Leah didn't have words for them either. But the words that she did remember, the ones that echoed, and that resonated within her were these. Leah, this is Jesus. This is Jesus. This holy night invites each one of us individually, but also as an entire community of faith, into the mystery of Jesus' incarnation. Jesus' incarnation, that's God becoming flesh, becoming a human being, a baby, being made flesh in a way in which the Father chose to reveal himself to the world. For God chooses to be known. The very one, the creator, the one who created the heavens and the earth, the one who brought forth life by his word and by his breath, chooses to be known and to make himself known to you. For he has come for you. God does not choose to be some cosmic deity, remote, hidden by smoke, veiled by mist, scary, thunder and lightning, but instead comes to us in a form so familiar, so fragile, so unassuming, that every person can encounter him. God does not create chaos in the world as if to incite pandemonium in hopes of some sort of utter confusion to befuddle the people and make them cower in fear. Instead, the Lord is incarnate. He is born. Born into the chaos to overcome it. Enters into human weakness in order to walk with you and me through it, even in the most troublesome and painful of all circumstances.
Oh, yeah.
Jesus, Emmanuel, the Word made flesh, we have seen God's love for us. Let us draw near to God in prayer with joy and hope. Wonderful Counselor, you increase our joy as the church gathers on this holy night to sing of our dear Savior's birth. May the story of salvation live in the hearts of all who sing of its wonders. We pray to the Lord. Mighty God, you have broken the yoke of sin's burden through the birth of your Son. Comfort those whose burdens distract them from the deeper peace of this holy night, and grant them a restful mind. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Everlasting Father, uphold all who are in sorrow, suffer in sickness or need of your divine goodness and mercy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Prince of Peace, may your reign be known in all places, that no fighting and unrest, and grant resolution to conflicts throughout the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Emmanuel, you strengthen and stir all who are assembled before your manger altar and receive the Holy Eucharist. Nourish us that we may witness the glory of God in a humble manger, and as witnesses, tell the world of your Word made flesh. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Word made flesh, we remember at the Eucharist table this night with flowers and memorials those who are dear to us. We give you thanks for their lives among us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Hear our prayers, gracious God, and bathe us always in the light of your Word made flesh, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Mary and Joseph went from Galilee to Bethlehem, and there found no room. So Jesus went from Galilee to Jerusalem, and was despised and rejected. As in the poverty of a stable Jesus was born, so by the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Holy Spirit. As your word became flesh, born of a woman on that night long ago, so on the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering therefore his birth and life among us, his death and resurrection, we await his coming again when all things will be restored in him. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come in glory.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on all gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them become for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until the same Christ who was born humbly in Bethlehem comes again in final victory, and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Amen.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Join our prayers with those of your servants of every time and every place, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Joseph, her husband, and all those dear to us who marked with the cross of Christ have gone before us, that together we may praise and glorify you with the joy of the shepherds and angels until you come again as victorious Lord of all.
Thank you.
body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen.
Thank you.
God, you give your only Son that we may know and love you with body, heart, and mind. United in the body of Christ, may we glorify and praise you in our lives for all that we have heard and seen in the wonder of the Word made flesh, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
When he came to us as a man, the Son of God scattered the darkness of the world and filled this holy night with his glory. May the God of infinite goodness scatter the darkness of sin and brighten your hearts with holiness.
Amen.
God sent his angels to shepherds to herald the great joy of our Savior's birth. May he fill you with joy and make you heralds of his gospel.
Thanks be to God.